Throughout their lives, they were the best of friends. Willie, the oldest, was born with dysentery, and when the Great War began in 1914, like so many other young men at the time, he went through the recruiting centre, where the officer took one look at him and told him to come back the next day and say he was 4 years older. And that's what Willie did.
School out for the summer, I arrive at grandmother's. Tense as the cold war, I walk across the yard to the shuddering green door. The dog, tired of touring the kitchen, thundering into it, scratching, latch, bolt, bars rattling, turning me rigid. Aloud his nose width, he shoots straight into me, panting, slavering, jumping at me, on me, round me, yelping some murderous language, his tongue hanging, his tail flailing. He lets me go.
When he returned home after the war, he met Jean, Jinty as she was better known, a tiny woman, true to her Baptist beliefs, and they married and raised two daughters in a little parlour house in Mersey Street.
Another character will always be dear to me was a wee woman called Maggie Jane. Maggie Jane was tiny and hung a bar at her grate. But when she laughed, you could have heard her in Woodvale Park at the top of the Shankill. Her and my granny had been friends for years. Apparently towards the end of the war, Maggie Jane fell ill, and my granny made extra dinner every day and took it round to her house on Boundary Street in a wee pot for the priceless sum of 5 bob a week, just till she got back on her feet. But it must have been the longest illness in history, because 40 years later she was still doing it and still only charging 5 bob a week.
If we meet a talking camel, we never ask it why. Just ask it, please, to step aside, to let a human by. For those who seek enlightenment in these enlightened times, it doesn't say, it doesn't show, it doesn't mean, it rhymes.
Taxi man. David Bacher. Taxi man. Brother. Uncle. Stand-in feller. Friend. Good friend. Compassionate. Kind. Patient.
And I think we all agreed that this is a fitting way to round off the evening's readings. Eric Conn's Gently at Sunset. Gently at sunset, let me take your hand and walk with you along the quiet shore where we have walked so many times before, leaving our fresh new footsteps in the sand. Where we will talk of love or joy or pain, leaving our soft words floating in the air, leaving our footprints resting tranquil there, till wind comes up and tide flows back again. Only the stars will know that we've been here, unless we paint a picture of the sand, or write our words that some may understand, may think about in some yet coming year.